good evening. The polls have closed. We are waiting on the very first numbers. We'll bring them to hand as soon as we have them. Welcome to this 2020 Multimedia Checkpoint Election Night Special. I'm Lisa Owen.
Corin, Dann, kia ora everybody. Lisa and I will be with you throughout the night tonight. Now, if you're just joining us and you're listening, but you also want to watch, we are streaming on the RNZ website across all our Facebook platforms. That's Freeview Channel 50, Sky Channel 83 as well. And we also have the state-of-the-art graphics and results as they come in.
Madly refreshing our computer screens, just hoping for at least one number. I'm Guyon, Espiner in the Situation Room. Always wanted a Situation Room, and I've been able to call it that tonight. It is exciting. Amy Adams, the former National MP and former Cabinet Minister, is with us, as is Jane Patterson, our political editor. I'm going to come to you, Amy. What are you thinking about National's result? Where are you seeing them? The polls have been saying sort of early 30s. Is that where you see it?
I think it's going to be a tough night for National. I think we all know that we're in the underdog position. Personally, I think Judith has run a really strong campaign in a very difficult situation, going up against popular prime minister, first term government, and then COVID. It was never going to be easy to climb that mountain. I think Judith has done a really good job with the situation she found herself in, but there's no getting away from it. We've had a tough campaign, a tough few months, and I think tonight's result will reflect that.
Is there any intel from the ground at the moment? What have you been hearing throughout the day? Anything?
Oh, look, I think everyone is, you know, when you're campaigning, you have to stay relentlessly positive. You can't do it any other way, and you've got to go out fighting for every vote as if everything is possible. And for a lot of individual MPs, you know, there's everything to play for. I'm going to be watching a lot of the electorate races really closely.
Which ones are you interested in?
Oh, I think it's the ones everyone's been talking about, certainly Auckland Central, Northland, the two Hamilton seats are always bellwether seats, Whanganui, Wairarapa, Tairi, Banks South. Peninsula, Hutt South. So there's a range of really interesting contests, Ohariu. So there'll be a lot of interesting results coming out through that. And the other thing that'll be interesting is having a look at turnout. You know, it's been such a bizarre campaign, such a strange year. Have New Zealanders been engaged? We've seen big advance voting numbers, but seeing how that turnout plays out will be interesting for the political junkies like the three of us in this room.
And Jane, most people are predicting a Jacinda Ardern second term, that she is leading the government, and it would be a big upset if she didn't. But we have no idea what the government is going to look like, and that's where the Greens and possibly New Zealand First come into play, right?
Absolutely, and I think that we could probably accept that Labour's going to be the dominant party at this stage if we can trust the polls so far. And I think the question is really going to be whether it's going to be a Labour majority government, whether they are going to need or want the Greens. And of course, one of the big things that we'll be looking out for tonight is New Zealand First. Winston Peters talking about that late surge. Is it too late? And if he does come
back... Let's have a look, though, at the very first numbers that are coming out. And remember that don't read too much into these, because it is just what I'm seeing is 0.2% of the votes counted here. But look, Labour 50%, 50.5% of the party vote, projected at 65 seats on those kind of numbers. National, as those of you watching on the screen could see, at 26% with 34 seats. ACT at 8.3%, which would give them 11. The Greens over the line, 7% with 9 seats. New Zealand First not making it. Correct me if I'm wrong, guys, because we are just looking at these things first straight up. What is it? 2.3 for New Zealand First on those numbers. Yeah. And look, you look at those numbers and you think, well, it's not wildly out of line. I mean, we're not going to call it at 10 past 7.
That'd be bold.
But an interesting first up. What do you think looking at those numbers? Just quickly.
Look, it is early, but it doesn't surprise me. I don't think New Zealand First are there. I think they're gone for money. Yep. You know, I know it's early, but I've been writing them off for some time. I think the Greens will get back. As you say, it's a question of, will Labour need them? Will they want them? And there's mixed views on that. But the other thing, of course, is there's this strange thing called wasted vote, which we all understand, which is that big vote that goes to parties who don't get in. And as that's redistributed, you can get parties with less than 50% effectively having a majority.
So let's just explain that to people, because it's something that the political junkies deal with all the time. But what happens to those parties that get under 5%?
Yeah, that's right. So if you vote for a party that doesn't win an electorate seat or doesn't get 5%, that vote, and it's a terrible name, is sort of called wasted vote. And then that gets divvied up between the parties that do make it. So if Labour were to poll, let's say, 46%, they might, by the time the wasted contested vote is reallocated, end up with almost an effective majority or very close to it. So 46% might not look like a majority, but it could end up being one.
And Jane, those numbers that we're seeing for those watching on television and hearing, if you're listening to our dulcet tones on the radio, it's Labor with 49% of the party vote there. Mm. Still under 1% of the votes counted. So how representative do you think that these are? We have to be a bit cautious, right, at this point.
Absolutely. I think what we can say is that the blocks on the left and the right have been relatively consistent, even in the opinion polls in the last couple of weeks. We have Labor there on 49.2, National on 26, again, very early. But those blocks have been consistent, and obviously these numbers are going to swing around. But the first thing that we can say is Labor making a strong showing out early, which is as expected, and National will really be wanting to pull that up. We've got 25.9, and the Greens up and down to an act. They're going to be really interesting to see. This will be giving them comfort. It's always a worry when they come straight in off the blocks, like New Zealand First, under that 5% threshold.
Thanks, guys. We'll be back to you soon. So there you are, Lisa. About 1% of the vote counted, and Labor on just shy of 50%.
Thanks, Guyon. That's right. We're up to 1.1% of the vote counted. We're all furiously refreshing our screens. Yeah, coming in fast. And we'll keep you updated as they roll in. Almost 2 million people have cast their votes early. And as we said, Labor on 49.9% on that very small return of 1.1% at this stage. We have heard from our reporter, though, that down at the ACT headquarters, there's a lot of cheering going on because they're coming in at the moment. I'm looking at the screen, finding their number, 7.3% on that small
Which would be about 10 seats.
10 seats, we're up to 1.2% counted. And David Seymour, the leader of ACT, is expected to arrive at his party headquarters very soon, and we'll go there when that happens.